What's your favorite number and why? Please leave a comment under this video so I can compare them all. And in the meantime, here were the answers given by some of the top people on YouTube. Now, I had to interview some of these people in unusual locations, like up trees and in toilets. So it's a bit of a hodgepodge, but it's also a bit of fun.
I'm Derek Muller from Veritasium, and my favorite number is I.
Where are the toilets at YouTube?
The square root of -1.
I'm Hank Green of SciShow, and also Crash Course and Vlogbrothers. And I'm a big fan of the number 2.
So, my name is Steve Spangler.
I am Michael from the channel Vsauce.
I grew up in a family of professional magicians.
My favorite number is the number 17, because I love making sevens with this little guy in the middle so that you know he's not a one. It's something that my dad always did, and I just adopted without ever thinking about it.
Number 13 has to be my absolute all-time favorite number.
Hi, I'm Angela from YouTube EDU.
If you really want to see a real magician's magic wand, it's exactly 13 inches long.
My number is 7, and I know it's kind of generic, but when I was really young, people told me that it was a lucky number.
17 was also the channel of Nickelodeon in Stillwell, Kansas, where I grew up.
So then I played a bunch of sports, and every single sport that I played, volleyball, tennis, whatever it was, my number was 7.
Michael from Vsauce does a little line, but you...
You know, when I went through a phase where I definitely drew it with a line, and then I just decided, you know what? Simpler is better.
I'm Alex from Bite-Sized, and my number is 27.
Every year on 7-7, on July 7th, I do something special. So I started it on 7-7-7, and I remember I went kayaking that day because I'd never been kayaking before.
As I was growing up, my favorite number was actually always my brother's age, but when I was 13, I decided that was silly, and so the last one stuck. And so my favorite number has always stuck at 27.
Oh, you do one of those things.
I do.
Why?
I don't know, I think it kind of distinguishes it. Sometimes my handwriting is terrible, and so my sevens look like ones, so I'll toss a little dash on it.
And 17 is also significant for another reason. How come I can't remember it? It's prime. What was the other thing? This is called not respecting your favorite number well enough.
I'm Destin. My number is 21. It's really hard to explain why.
My name is Mike Rignetta from PBS Idea Channel, and my number is 10-24.
Hang on, what's with that?
Zero fill. It's a compulsion just from handwriting so many. My handwriting is really bad.
I'm Caitlin Hendrickson, work at YouTube. My number is 16.
I'm John Green of the Vlogbrothers, and my favorite number is 37, because it was the dorm room that I first lived in when I went to boarding school.
Growing up, I wanted to drive, so 16 in the US is when you can drive.
Do you do that with your sevens?
I do that with my sevens, and I do my ones like this too.
All right, dude, 1024, why?
1024. It's a very sort of nice round number in computing. Having a degree in computer science, it has a magical quality about it, I guess.
So actually, I also have a little bit of synesthesia. So numbers have colors for me. So 2 is green and 7 is yellow. So 27 is actually a very greenish yellow number.
You've heard of synesthesia. I don't have it, but I think it's amazing. But to me, there's certain sharpnesses for certain numbers.
My name's Henry, I make Minute Physics videos, and my favorite number is J.
My first kiss wasn't until I was 18, so it was the last full year I lived before I knew what lips felt like.
And I always wanted to have a sweet 16 birthday party, which my parents never gave me, but but I'll make up for that maybe when I turn 30 in a couple of years.
Oh! And the 17th floor is the floor that I lived on in New York when I lived in Brooklyn. But I almost actually lived on the 16th floor because the building skipped the 13th, right? The elevators went right from 11 to 12 to 14, 15, 16, 17. Boom. He's been with me my whole life, basically.
So certain numbers are sharper than others. So like a 1 would be kind of sharp, a 2 is very dull. But a 3 is very, very high. They have the sharpness to them. I don't know what it is. And so it's like this. And if I take 3 and 7 and multiply them together, I get 21. And for some reason, 21 seems to be this very bright, cheerful, you know, proper number.
So how high will 21 be on the sharpness scale?
Oh, it's way up here. It's like, it's off the page.
I am Patrick JMT, and my favorite number, or one of my favorite numbers, is 17 29.
Now, before you say J isn't a number, I mean, J is a number.
I'm CGP Gray, and my favorite number is 0. I like 0 because it's not an obvious number. Right? You can have counting systems where there's 1 thing, 2 things, 3 things, 4 things, but mathematics existed for a long time without having a 0 as part of it. So it's a number, but it also isn't anything in and of itself.
I'm Vi Hart. You have to tell me what a number is, if I'm going to choose one. Alright, I'm having trouble with this.
Similar to the way I is the square root of negative 1, but what that actually means is that I squared is negative 1. J squared is plus 1, but J is not 1.
But one of the other things that I like about 0 is that it's the kind of unsung workhorse of the mathematical world. You have 0, and then if you want to make 10, you put a 1 in front of that 0, and now we have 10 things, and people focus on the 1, but it's really the 0 that is doing all the work to make that a 10. And then the same thing with, right, 100 or 100,000, right? We keep adding zeros, we keep adding nothing, but making the numbers much, much larger.
Students in school are like, oh, what's I? That's not really a number. And then there's J. J's a good one. It's already taken.
You know that Derek, you can see on there that Derek chose I. You chose J. Why? What's the difference? Why'd you pick that one?
Who wants to pick the team that's going to win all the time? Who wants to pick the New York Yankees, you know? You want to pick the underdog. You want to pick the... You don't want to pick what everyone else has already gone for.
Star. Which, it's not a number. It's like a number. The thing is, it's smaller than all the positive numbers. And it's larger than all the negative numbers. But it's not zero. It gets confused with zero. This is one of those weird things you get in combinatorial game theory. And I like it. I think the very not numberness of it. I think that's what appeals about a lot of these numbers to us. Like the weirdness of J, the weirdness of I, the weirdness of zero.
I like zero's non-obviousness and its incredible usefulness.
Does J exist?
Does J exist? I mean, does any number exist?
So what are we going to be talking about today is whether or not numbers exist. We're going to be thinking about 3 different schools of thought on this.
Don't forget to leave your favorite number and the reason under the video. And if you're wondering what I'm going to do with this, well, I don't exactly know yet, but when I decide, I'll probably let you know via the Numberphile Facebook and Twitter, so make sure you're following us on there.